old house in St. Paul went up in flames. Today, we spoke with someone working to help the homeowners get back on their feet. That house, by the way, built in the 1860s and is on a street in the city of St. Paul with many historic homes. Carol Evans' Ken Erdahl has that story tonight.
The fire that tore through this historic home on St. Paul's Cathedral Hill has been extinguished for a day, but neighbors are still stopping and staring in disbelief at a building that predates the cathedral itself.
It's horrifying.
Kim Anbaugh's son, Dana, lived in the house with his girlfriend and her family. It was his girlfriend's grandparents who bought the home in the mid-70s and were still the primary residents.
Yeah, they've been restoring this house ever since they got it.
Today, the family worked to remove and salvage what photos and artifacts they still could, knowing much of it, including hand-carved woodwork throughout, is now soaked and charred beyond repair. The fire, which started just after 11 a.m. Tuesday, burned through the interior so quickly that 60 firefighters had to retreat, fighting defensively from the outside as the second floor collapsed on the first.
It's hard to start over. The cats passed away too from the fire, so that was really hard to handle.
Everyone else inside the home made it out safely, including three people who rented a third floor apartment from the owners, who are in their 70s.
And that was the income, you know, to pay the mortgage and whatever else they need.
It's why Kim's son has started a GoFundMe page in hopes of helping the owners recover, though they're still unsure when, if ever, they'll be able to begin restoration again.
They're going to need a lot of help. So they have nothing left.
Family members believe the fire started somewhere in the area where you're looking right now. They say there's a storage room up on the second floor, and that's their best guess as to where all of it began. The fire investigators are also looking into that area, but for now, there's no timetable for finding a source. Back to you.